Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my beloved children. I was asked about pets. Now, if you have a pet, what is a pet? Some animal or some creature that you keep with you, around you, maybe in the house, maybe in your yard, depending on what exactly it is. If you have a pet, you know, you become close to it sometimes. What do people have as pets? Some people have fish. Wow, as pets, yeah? It's a little bit difficult because to keep that fish tank clean and to feed the fish and to be cleaning it all the time, you need a lot of time and effort. And if you're living in a country where the electricity goes, sometimes the oxygen pipes that are within the water that you have to install inside there, if they turn off for longer than a certain time, your fish might die. So that's also something to consider. Some people have birds. Birds are not so easy to keep, but they're okay. You have a cage. You can put a bird in a cage on condition that you're going to look after it. You're not allowed to cage a bird if you're not going to feed it and you're going to torture it. So if you want birds, it's okay. You can have birds. Maybe a bird is a little bit easier sometimes than fish, according to some people, but you need to give grains. You need to give some water every day, subhanAllah, to these birds. And sometimes if you're gone on holiday, you need to be very careful because who is going to look after your birds? So to have pets is not easy because sometimes you might not be able to go on a holiday. And if you do, you might have to spend money for someone to look after your pets, either at home or wherever they are. Some people have cats and subhanAllah, we have some cats. And cats are not so easy to look after, especially when you have a small home. If you have a big home, a nice huge house, then you can keep those cats. And those cats, you need to have a litter tray. You need to feed them every so often. You need to know how to feed them. Sometimes you need to give them some medicine, some injections, etc. And you need to know how to look after the cat. Some of the cats mess the house sometimes, but not so much. You need to train them. You need to know how to train them and speak to people who, or check online from people who know how to do how to look after these cats. So some people have cats, some people have chickens, ducks, some people have so many other things. Some people have chickens, they eat them, they end up eating them after that because they want chicken burgers, they want everything else, subhanAllah. But anyway, so when we have these pets, we get attached to these pets. We actually get attached to these pets, which means we start feeling, you know, you stroke the pet and you feel the pet and you actually get close to the pet and you become connected to that pet. It becomes your friend, right? It knows you. Some people have rabbits. Wow. Recently, I know of some of my friends who got some rabbits and we have some rabbits as well. Now, rabbits are difficult because they're smelly sometimes. Yeah. And sometimes they multiply so much, it's not so easy. So when that happens, do you know, you need to have a place for them outside. You need to have a warm space depending on the country you come from. And you also need to be prepared to look after all the little rabbits that are going to come about because they multiply very, very quickly. Now, you might want to ask about dogs. In Islam, we can only have dogs if the dog is a security dog, meaning it looks after the property. If it's a farming dog, if it's a hunting dog, or if it's a dog that's going to help a blind person. But we're told those are the reasons that you could have a dog. And then two, you need to know where to keep it. You have to have a kennel for it, not inside your house, but in the yard somewhere. So you need to learn a little bit more about dogs. We would prefer to have the other animals, especially if we're just having pets. Now, if you do have a security dog or a guide dog or something, it's okay. But you must be kind to these dogs. You must look after them. They are trained dogs. The hunting dogs are trained and so on. So we need to learn about it. Now, if any one of these pets die, we'll be very sad, very sad. Especially if you're connected to it a lot, we become sad. And when we become sad, what happens? Well, some people say, will I see my cat in Jannah? You know, will I be united with my dog in paradise in the hereafter? Can I ask for forgiveness for the dog or the cat? My child, you don't need to ask for forgiveness for the dog or the cat, because the dog or the cat didn't, it wasn't responsible anyway to fulfill the duties unto Allah of ibadah and worship like we are. Animals don't have the level of intellect and the brain of a human being. So they're not responsible as human beings to fulfill these things. So we don't ask for forgiveness for animals. And when we say, will the dog be in Jannah? Islam teaches you something. Islam says, don't worry about the others. Don't worry about your dogs and pets where they're going to be. You need to worry about yourself. So if I am going to be in paradise, once I get there, when I make it there, I will definitely get whatever I want in paradise. But I can't think about it from now. I've got to think about it then. For now, Islam says only focus on you getting that paradise, subhanAllah. So in that way, it will really be amazing. We shouldn't be worried about, will I get my cat or not? Because sometimes what shaitan makes us do is, we're worried about our cats and that, but we don't even pray as a result. And we become bad people and we cheat and steal and deceive and we disrespect our parents and we don't do the right thing. We spend our time doing the wrong things and then we expect the cat to be in paradise, but we're not going to be there. May Allah not do that to us. So don't worry about the cat, not at all. We shouldn't even worry about those. Because when you are worried about yourself and you make it to Jannah, to paradise, you definitely will not go wrong. You will have so much. Everything you want, you get it in paradise. You know, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, and even the Quran says, that in Jannah, you get what you want. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ Allah says, to those who are in Jannah, in paradise, they will get what? Ever they wish in paradise. So I can't say it from now that I want this and I want that. Some people say, I want the latest phone in Jannah, but it's not going to be the latest anymore. The latest phone now is maybe an S21 maybe, or an iPhone 13 perhaps. And you know what? Next year or later this year, it's not going to be the latest anymore. So you can't ask for these things. You have to worry about you getting to paradise. So be a good person and inshallah, don't worry about these cats. If your pet has passed away, you bury the pet. You know, there is no salat janazah on a pet. Remember that. I've been asked this question a few times by people that do, how do we do janazah for my pet? It may sound funny, but the question is, you know, innocent children ask these questions. Meaning the issue is, we've heard this and people ask questions, there's no janazah. You know, janazah is a prayer to seek forgiveness for the dead human being. That's what it is. So you don't do that. But you do bury it. You can bury the animal. SubhanAllah. So what you do is you can dig a little hole, you know, going deep enough that that particular animal will not come out if the rain comes or maybe the floods come or something happens, then the body won't come, meaning the carcass meaning the dead body, the dead animal, will not actually come out, but it will be underneath. And then you can leave a little gap and bury it so that it decomposes back into the soil. So these are a few small rules that I thought I'd ask you, meaning I'd let you guys know because some of you have been asking. So I hope you enjoyed this session and I hope it enlightened you. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.